After giving my introduction in the last clip I just made, now I'm going to give you an introduction about the nervous system. This is all the things I wrote about the introduction of your nervous system. First of all, starting from here, the top one, the neuroanatomy. Now, what is neuroanatomy? We know the word anatomy is derived for structure and location of different organs of the body, and neuron means neurons including the brain and spinal cord. So if we put neuro and anatomy together, we get neuroanatomy. So if they say what is neuroanatomy, it is basically the study of the structure and location of the neurons in our brain, and this is the brain. Sorry, my diagram is like this. And the spinal cord. So its structure and location of neurons in different parts of the brain and spinal cord, that branch of anatomy is called your neuroanatomy. Now, what is nervous system? Nervous system is a very important system of the body. This system controls our entire body movements, functions, etc. If this system is not present, life is dead. So function of this nervous system is basically the conduction of impulses, which we will study when we study detail about how impulses are conducted and how coordinated that how they're going to coordinate. So how coordination is done, like for example, if we want to do movement, we want to do running, then which limbs, which muscles have to work, which will relax, contract, all that function of conduction of impulses and how they're going to result is basic the function of nervous system. Then we should know the cell. The basic functional unit and the cells of this nervous system is called the neurons, which you can see in this diagram. This is a basic functional unit diagram structure of the neuron, which is functional unit of nervous system. And it consists of a cell body and your dendrites and axon. Basically, the cell body that is present on the inside, this is known as the cell body of the neuron. And the center, this is called as the nucleus. This is basically a collection of the cell body present inside your nervous system. And if this center of cell body is present outside the nervous system, we call it as the ganglion. Then these long elongated fibers that are moving out from the nucleus of the neuron, this is called as your axon. So that was basically the structure of your neuron, which is the cell and functional unit of your nervous system. Now, if there is a cell, so obviously there's gonna have to be a tissue. What is the tissue? The tissue is the nervous tissue. The very important tissue, nervous tissue, and important function is that it is unrepairable. So if there's any injury, any damage to the nervous tissue, it will not repair, and as a result, all the function or the coordination that has been performed by your brain and your spinal cord will not occur, and the person will result in many diseases. Let's take an example, like if a person has an injury to the nervous tissue, there's a nervous tissue injury, and then you will notice that there are some patients who say that we have difficulty in our muscles moving. Why is that so? That is because the nervous tissue is damaged. It will not conduct impulses, axons will not leave and will go to the brain or spinal cord or to the motor function, and as a result, muscles will not perform and the person will result in paralysis. That was about that. Now we will come to the types of the nervous system. The nervous system is further classified in your three types. Number one, central nervous system. Number two, peripheral nervous system. Number three, the autonomic nervous system. The central nervous system consists of your brain and spinal cord. The peripheral nervous system consists of your nerves, the cranial nerves that will move out from your brain, and the spinal nerves that will move out from the spinal cord. Cranial nerves are 12 in pairs, and the spinal nerves are 31 in pairs, divided into the five regions, which are known as the cervical, your thoracic, lumbar, sacral, and coccygeal. There are seven cervical, 12 thoracic, 5 lumbar, 5 sacral, and 1 coccygeal. That was about the peripheral nervous system. Then coming to the last, autonomic nervous system, you may be familiar as we studied in our high school classes as well in our metric and FSC about the autonomic nervous system divided into two, sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. The sympathetic nervous system is that nervous system which is stimulated during emergency condition. Like, for example, let me give you a very simple example and that will help you make a clear concept about sympathetic and parasympathetic. Now, any student, whether he or she is medical, Even high school, mid school, whenever you have some sort of exams, you get some sort of stress or tension that, oh my God, this course is so big, how are we gonna do it? So you get stress, tension. So that time the nervous system that is functioning is the sympathetic nervous system. And then when exams are done and you're like, oh, finally we're fine, exams done, now we can relax. At that time, the nervous system that is activated is the parasympathetic nervous system. And that was about it. Now, coming to the brain, giving you just an introduction about your brain and spinal cord. Details will come when we will study the detailed structure of the brain and spinal cord in the upcoming videos. The brain is further divided into three parts. We can see this one, forebrain. This is the midbrain. Here you can see this one. And these are forming the hind. These are the three types of the brain. The forebrain consists of your cerebrum and diencephalon. The midbrain, no particular organs or structures have been identified, so we just give it the name midbrain because it is present between the forebrain and the hindbrain. And the hindbrain is further divided into three types known as the medulla oblongata, pons, and cerebellum. So this all together forms the brain. Then coming to the spinal cord, we know in that the peripheral nervous system consists of the spinal nerves divided into your five types according to regions which they supply. The nerves in our cervical region are called as the cervical spinal nerves, which are 8 in number. The spinal nerves in our thoracic region are called as the thoracic spinal nerve, 12 in number. The ones in the lumbar region, they are called as the lumbar nerve spinal nerve. The ones which are in the sacral region, sacrospinal nerves, and the one in coccygeal are the coccygeal spinal nerves. Now, one thing you should know that the spinal cord, this cord, it ends at the lumbar region. Here at the L1 and L2, it ends in the lumbar region of the spinal cord. In adults, it is present between L1 and L2 region, and in children, it is at L2 level. Then, why we say that this is spinal nerves, they can supply the sacral and the coccygeal nerve? It is because at the lumbar region, they form a plexus, which I will show you in the detailed structure of spinal cord, that they're going to give plexus, which and those plexus then move towards the sacral and coccygeal. That is why we have included the sacral and coccygeal regions in the spinal nerve course. Right? So that was a little bit introduction about your brain and your spinal cord. Now coming to the cross section of the spinal cord, seen here. Here you can see a cross-section of the spinal cord consisting of two matters. The one here on the inside is called the gray matter. The one outside is called as the white matter. Gray matter is basically due to the collection of your cell bodies. They form the gray matter. And the collection of axons which are leaving, they give a white appearance. So that is the white matter. As we studied that these axons, they will leave the brain and enter into your spinal cord. That is why the outside of the spinal cord is white and inside is your gray. Then it consists of two horns or roots called as the posterior horns and the anterior horns. The posterior horns, they will conduct the impulses from the brain towards the spinal cord, and the anterior will take the impulses away from the spinal cord. And the other thing is that here the posterior root, there is a posterior root ganglion, the swelling in the posterior root known as the posterior root ganglion. Now, basically, their function, structure, everything will be studied in the detail. Remember, this is just an introduction to your nervous system. In between here, you have a commissure. This is called as the gray commissure, consisting of the cavity called as the central canal. Now, these brain and spinal cords, they are surrounded and protected by some sort of connective tissue. Those are called as meninges, divided into three layers. The outermost, that is just present beneath the brain and the spinal cord, is called as the dura mater, indicated by the blue color in my video. Then the green color membrane, you can see that is present deep to this dura mater, that is called as the arachnoid layer. And the space between the arachnoid and this pia, this one, this upper green, this is called as the arachnoid space. And the deep motor layer that is present in the brain and spinal cord, that is called as the pia mater. So this was all called as the introduction of your nervous system. Hope you have a clear concept now. And may you guys help and do good in your neuroanatomy. Thumbs up. And if you want more videos, kindly subscribe my channel. Thank you.